Hello and welcome to Conscious TV. My name is Eleonora Gilbert and today my guest is Faisal Muqaddam. Did I pronounce it okay? You want to say it again? Muqaddam?
Muqaddam.
That's better. Okay. Faisal is the originator. I'm going to put my glasses on actually. Faisal is the originator of the Diamond Logos teaching and he's a psycho-spiritual teacher and has been teaching in the Middle East, the USA, and for 35 years, and more, and for the last 25 years in Europe, Italy, Germany, Denmark, etc. Faisal was born in Kuwaiti, and he's a trained Reichian and bioenergetic therapist, and he has studied different systems of growth with esteemed teachers such as Tartan Tuku Rinpoche, I'm sorry if I'm not pronouncing it correctly, Dr. Claudio Naranjo, as well as Middle Eastern Sufi teachers, which I thought was really fascinating with the conversation that we had last night. And he's currently practicing and teaching in California and in Europe. So, now we have Ian has interviewed Faisal last year, and I personally was so excited about the conversation that we had afterwards. And on Conscious TV, we have a whole series on the Enneagram. And Faisal is going to be talking to me today about exploring the essential Enneagram as a spiritual path to awakening. Tell us about what is the essential Enneagram.
Okay. Hello, everybody, and thanks for the opportunity. There is a dimension of spirituality we call the essential domain, relating that title to different aspects of differentiated being. We have the being undifferentiated. It differentiates itself in myriads of qualities. Some are major archetypes, like love, beauty, clarity, power, will. Each one of them is an essential domain, mm-hmm. is an essential quality. We discover a lot of those major qualities that we integrate them in our work. And the fascinating thing was the opening to realizing that these fixations that we so much looked at from a psychological perspective, mental, it led to huge limitations, and the teachers who taught it, you know, warned us against, like, not to use it this way. But by time it became as an ego reduction way, as like thinking by continually reducing the students to their fixation, they will be able to see it and somehow magically or will break and they will be awakening.
And when you talk about fixation, I just want to comment the fact that we also say type.
Yeah.
So fixation and type is the same thing.
Yes. Enneagram yeah. type or Enneagram fixation.
Fixation, yes.
Yes. And the idea by the name is that part of our mind got fixated, unable to move, unable to be resilient, and maintaining one job, one quest, is to recreate this archetype, this, you know. And we didn't look so much into why is that, you know. We understand a little bit that it was the maneuver of that the child adapted to resolve some of the difficulties in life, in childhood. And there are so many theories that maybe we're born in it, you name it. There's so much complexity. But there was very little saying, what is this type is preserving? Is it just a mental construct? Psychological construct, or does it come from an origin? And if so, what is that origin? By inquiring into that, through grace, through inquiry, through revelations, the picture began to be revealed that each type is an imitation and an attempt and the preservation of one quality of essence or one dimension of essence.
Right, okay. You know?
So then the picture started to shine. It is not just a psychological repetitive pattern. It is really an attempt to revive and to connect a certain aspect of our being, a certain aspect of essence. Then little by little, in 13 years, the map unfolded.
Right.
And the dimension of each fixation is trying to reach or preserve became more vivid. And in our work, knowing, you know, those essential domains, it was then great to weave the ennea-type with the quality. And by time it opened deeper and deeper that by undoing or by integrating, you know, the essential domain from which the fixation has originated, it led to greater freedom, it led to discovery of the essential dimension, and that led to liberation.
Right. Can you give us an example of, you know, the various different essential qualities for each type, for each fixation?
Okay. The one that fascinates me the most, and then I will come to, is the, for me, was the guidance, the element, the aspect of essence that has to do with the guide, you know. And because my love for the guide was so great, because it orchestrated this unfoldment, you know, the psychological domain, the essential domain, and wove it in such an unbelievable intricacy and richness and wisdom that no ego can do, I love this aspect, the guidance, and it is to me the crown jewel of the essential teachings.
Right.
We call this the guide, or we call it the objective perception, or the diamond guidance, or objectivity, right? Mm-hmm. This quality is related to an aspect of essence that has to do with knowing.
Right.
The ability to know, and the ability to have differentiated wisdom, guidance, all of that. And it helped so much in our unfoldment. Yet this quality is beyond knowledge.
Right. See?
So it is related so much, for example, to the five in the Enneagram.
The five.
In the Enneagram. So the five, their obsession or their drive and their inspiration is to know. To know or not to know.
Mm-hmm.
It's not to be or not to be, that's the nine.
Right.
But to know or not to know is the, you know, five. And you see five in the fixation, in the level of the fixation, they are so much fascinated with knowing. So they are so much knowledgeable, you know, and there is no end for that starvation for knowledge. So they accumulate, you know, so much knowledges and all of that, and sometimes it's overboard, sometimes it is so wonderful to know. In this process, their preoccupation, the underground of their longing for knowing and for understanding is a longing for this aspect of being.
Right.
This aspect of being, one manifestation of it is knowledge.
Right.
Its essence is the knower.
Right. Yeah.
So,
okay.
Yeah, so the five in the Enneagram is pursuing this quality, but taking the information, the knowledge, to be the knower. They don't know that the knower is an aspect of essence that is made of jewel, made of diamond, and has ability to differentiate the absolute into knowledge, but also into all kind of manifestation. They get fascinated by the knowledge and forget the knower.
Right.
And confuse knowledge with knower.
And the guidance and the knower are there?
Are the same aspect.
The same aspect.
Yes.
Okay.
So this aspect of essence is perceived as a diamond. It enables the mind to be clear, to be objective. It brings the ability to know, but it is not just about knowing. So it is not bound by the realm of knowledge, as intellectual knowledge, nor by inquiry. You know, it is the source of inquiry, and if you connect in your inquiry, you reach it, but then you drop inquiry and you hold the knower. Then inquiry turns into insight, into realization. This jewel, you know, sometimes seen, they call it as the angel of revelation. It reveals to you what's in the unconscious. It reveals to you the hidden kingdom. So it functions in multidimensionality. It is not just in the head and knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
It comes in the heart and orchestrate beauty, art, poetry, you know, intuition. It comes into the belly and orchestrate impeccability, groundedness, the warrior path, the gentle warrior path. But often that it gets confused with knowledge. And right. those who idealize this quality take it to the head and use it as never-ending information of knowledge, which is beautiful, but overwhelming.
Right.
You know. So in the inquiry about what is this five trying to do,
yeah.
realize that they are really trying to reach this quality, and when they reach this knowingness, this diamond dimension in our essence, then great deal of resolution happens to their fixation.
Right, okay. You
know? So the five is the attempt to be the knower.
Yes.
You know? And when they reach it, they are not anymore obsessed with knowledge.
Right.
Because knowledge has no end.
And when it comes to the other types, yes. I know you are fascinated with the five. Any other types that you can use as an yes. example?
Yes, so I can sure. go over the whole map. Discovered, you know, it was really fascinating, this discovery, that the one in the Enneagram, you know, is obsessed or embodying and conflicting about this quality of appreciative love.
Right.
And conditional appreciative love.
This is type one.
That's type one.
Yes. You know.
And this appreciative love is very sweet, fluffy kind of love. You know, it is not like powerful kind of love. It's fluff. It's like cotton candy, we call
right.
it. You know, sweet, fluffy. It has to do with the quality of essence we call pink.
Yes.
Pink essence, which is a mixture of red essence and brilliant essence.
Right.
They mix, they create softness, they create fluffiness. And the one in the Enneagram, living all their life, trying to maintain this quality, to generate it, you know. So their fixation is not just an ego pattern. It's trying to mobilize even the system.
Right.
To affect certain organs, certain attitude, you know, to keep generating this quality.
Yes.
And they generate a lot of it. And paradoxically, they always feel they don't have enough.
Right.
So the fixation is an overwork, you know,
right.
trying to generate this quality. And since they, every now and then, get angry, they fall from the grace of unconditional acceptance and conditional love, they constantly feel wounded, and the story keeps
right.
going on. You know,
right.
The fixation.
So they feel wounded, and they seek this pink love.
Yeah.
And they keep getting re-wounded. And so, yes. It's a never-ending story.
Never-ending. The moment they get angry, they are not anymore pink essence. You know?
Right.
They feel that they have fallen from their highest ideal.
Right. You know? And to feel that pink essence, what is a one to do? Because the quality is there, is present in all of us, in all
yes.
the various types. So what is one to do?
I mean, for when, for example, we all have this quality, but when's are like a nuclear fusion of pink.
Right.
They have so much of it.
Yes.
But something within them does not see it, does not allow them to experience it enough, you know, always making them feel hurt and failure because they haven't healed the world from, you know, their attempt to heal it. This pain, this continuous attempt to heal this ideal quality and actualize it, and they fall short from it, it makes the ego an ongoing process, like a gerbil on a wheel. It never ends, generating so much pink, but doesn't, you know, do it. So in our work, first step is to be conscious.
Right, you know, to be conscious of the pattern.
Of the pattern, you know,
right.
that their fixation is explained what it does, you know, how it's doing it, in terms of the mental pattern, then
yeah.
the you know, emotional pattern, physical pattern, then little by little go to the essential domain. And by doing so, we also explore their childhood. What happened?
Sure.
You know, what was needed in the family. You know? So little by little, we deepen the inquiry. At the same time, we... by recognizing the pattern, and it's around a certain quality, their consciousness begin to differentiate,
mm-hmm.
begin to click when the quality is there,
yeah.
and begin to see when it is gone, and yeah. the anxiety that comes when it is gone. So they begin to know their specific anxiety.
Right.
You know, and their specific resistance and their specific superego, it becomes more and more in focus,
right,
more and more orchestrated. Yeah. And we also focus on the, not only the feeling of this quality, but the organ in the body that is ruled by it.
Okay. Okay. I want to stop you there for two things, first of all, so that we can weave all of this in the various other types. And
yes,
we discussed earlier that there is a family whole,
yes,
that occurs, and that's when the soul, let's say, takes on a particular aspect,
yes,
that it constantly tries to come back to and reach.
And resolve, yes.
Like in this particular case, type one is this pink love.
Yes.
But also, there is an organ that is related to that particular typology, that particular fixation. So the family whole and the organ related to type one, what is it?
The family whole is the, that, shall I explain the family whole?
Or yes, okay. And we can
then
kind of go in and out.
The
yes,
essential, you know. The theory is that we as human beings are close to Swiss cheese, full of holes. There's something missing,
yeah,
here. Something.
Okay.
And our parents were like that too.
Sure.
You know, we wish them to be these glorious gods and goddesses, but they were humans and gods and goddesses within certain range. So at one time in the family, let's say the family is going through a conflict, you know, which is normal, you know.
Yes.
And at one time, let's say, mom and dad, they close their heads. They don't understand each other. So there is impairment with the quality that can be generated by the head. Let's say clarity, yeah, precision, brilliance, overview. Another time, the parents, maybe they can understand each other, but they are hurt. They
right,
don't want to open their hearts to each other.
So in the case of the five, for instance, you know, the family whole would have been lack of understanding?
Yes. It'd be the diamond body which understand, bring understanding, was impaired.
Right.
You know, they don't want to understand.
And the child develops that desire to
solve it. So
to
I'll come
it,
to that, you know, by saying the belly, what is lost. And the belly was, what was lost is basic sanity, basic groundedness, basic ease. You know, and if the family is anxious, insecure, ungrounded, so the belly center that has to do with the groundedness, with the relaxation, with ease, is impaired, is not functioning fully, which means the quality, one quality or another of the belly is blocked, or one quality or another of the heart is blocked, or the head. So a soul comes to incarnate or reincarnate, and it gravitates to a certain hole depending on its karma, let's say, right?
Yes.
So this soul, this baby, land in the womb, and because of the merged quality, mom is blocking, let's say, her heart, dad is blocking his heart. The baby, in developing its heart prenatally in the womb, as a structure, get, due to merging with the environment, get affected by the absence of this quality.
Right.
So that is, to me, born in sin. We are
right,
born in a missing aspect of us. Sin to me is a diagnostic thing, it's not a judgment.
Sure,
you know,
sure.
It's something is missing,
yeah,
you know? So sin is a disconnect. So the soul of the baby in developing the body and the organs, it struggles so much, let's say, around the heart.
Right.
And the heart is closed, and the heart, let's say, generate gold, let's say, golden essence. Sweet, love, that is, you know, has so much richness to it. The baby feels its golden essence keep depleting. They block it.
Mm-hmm.
Their heart is not open. But the baby is a mighty soul at that time. It's in connection with source. It struggles, it generates gold. Then merges, it loses. Then it generates it. This process makes the golden essence the most dominant quality, because like it's survival happening around,
yes,
it. So the system generates it more and more. So that child becomes so much gold, but through the attempt of releasing and losing it,
yes,
it creates subtle membranes of resistance,
right,
to that quality. So they generate more, but they feel it less.
Right,
so
yes.
When they are born and the ego begins to develop in the first year, second year, all of those things, the preoccupation with this quality, without knowing what it is, they feel it's some kind of love. And when this love comes, mom is happy. Dad is happy. Their hearts soften. They begin to feel this is really the most important quality in existence. They begin to develop some aspect of ego. Let's say that half of the ego mechanism is based on to gold or not to gold.
Right. Yeah.
So then little by little, the ego get more entangled, more difficult, separate more and more from the gold, it generates more and more of the gold. Then this domain becomes so much dominant in the essential level, but yeah. also in the ego.
Yes.
The ego then limits its perception of reality, get limited, and focuses on how can I generate this?
Yes.
It's so important.
Yeah.
Right? Then that leads to an ego, mm-hmm. you know, ego development,
yes.
that get fixated around this quality.
Yeah.
Because it's the survival for the family, the healing of the family.
Yeah.
Then it expands as a cosmic approach. Life is, or our dilemma is solved by love.
Yeah.
While five in the Enneagram says to love or not to love is okay.
Yeah.
You know, but if we don't understand, what's the use of love?
Yes.
So
the fixation is on an understanding.
Yes, and understanding and knowledge. This one is on love, this one on stability. So each fixation is like a jeweled aspect of being
yes.
that got overly, you know, developed.
Yes.
And the ego is afraid to go and experience other domains.
Right.
It's focused as a guardian.
Yes.
So the fixation, you can think of it as a guardian, as a representation of an essential domain.
So the golden domain would be representative of the type two, because you talked about the heart.
Yes, yes. The two, for example, is so much about sweet, precious love.
Right.
You know? So like a two will see pink love, feels, oh yeah, that's sweet, but that's baby love. You know?
Right.
And goes to like another love, which is pomegranate, you know, ecstatic, passionate love. That's not enough, you know.
Right.
But you need most authentic love. It has to be 24 karat gold.
Okay.
You know. So then the two is so occupied yes. by offering the most precious love.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And then not only to offer this love, but also how can they manifest it?
Yes.
So they turn their whole system into a vehicle, into an instrument that manifests preciousness
yes.
and beauty.
Yes.
And that's another aspect of essence. We call it the chandelier, the
right.
body of jewels, the body yes. of manifestation, expression, you know.
Okay.
That's when you go visit like two's house, it's like a chandelier. My sister has like 10 chandeliers in the house, you know, she's a two.
Right, okay.
So to bring the festive, the beauty, you know.
So just so that we don't miss out the type one, because we didn't quite finish the type one, so that was the pink love. And was there any other aspects related to the type one?
It's a subtle idea, which is the essential domain
yes.
is made of dimensions
yes.
and vehicles, we call them.
Yes.
The dimension is like, there is like you make the whole field of awareness as pink ocean of love.
Right.
Within it,
yes.
there are variety of qualities.
Yes.
You can have a sense of individuated pink person.
Right.
Who feel, I am really appreciatively loving. The other one says, I not only want to be it, I also want to manifest it.
Right.
So they go to pink chandelier.
Right.
The other one says, I am not only want to manifest it, but I want to know objectively what it is. So they develop pink diamond. So within the field,
yes.
within that dimension, there are many qualities.
Right.
That's
okay.
why when you look at ones, see, they are different.
Yes.
They are all about the same quality,
yes.
but this one want to make it personal, this one want to
yeah.
make it impersonal, this
yeah.
want to make celebration of it.
Okay.
You know, so.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
So if we move on down to the three now, because we just talked about the two.
Yes.
What is that?
A three is they sense that the family is missing contact and connection with each other.
Right.
Yeah. So they feel they really want to connect with everyone.
Yes.
And feel their needs and what is needed and generate it.
Right.
Very close to the two.
Right. Yeah.
The two feels what is needed through merging.
Yes.
You know, they melt with the other person and feel it. That's the affinity. And the chandelier manifested. And the three, they have the quality of essence that it can connect with the other person.
Right.
You know, it can really tune in and be one with them and feel it. And then they generate it, whether for a person, with a person, or for the family, or for the community. If you feel like, you know, what is needed now, this, you feel it, and then you set, you know, the Ferrari, and you go. It's they are generator like that.
Right.
So
right.
The quality of contact and bonding and healthy attachment is a quality of essence. You know, that has a feeling of resiliency. It's a conscious substance that senses there. You know, and the generator is another quality.
Mm-hmm.
So the combination of them is a magnificent quality of essence that optimizes the grand vehicle of the human structure in the essential domain.
Right.
There's a vehicle that's the ultimate vehicle that embody the personal essence.
You know? And what is that vehicle? Can you name it?
We name it in our work the stupa, or at least I name it the stupa.
Yes. You know,
the pearly stupa.
The pearly stupa.
Yeah.
Okay.
This quality is made of many jewels,
right.
And each jewel differentiate being into an energetic field, and it's a dynamo.
Right.
You know, those who don't have it don't function in life.
Right.
They can be couch potato or couch mango.
Sure.
They can be sweet, but no dynamo.
Yeah.
So this
not
one,
generator.
Not generator. That's why it's called the heart of enlightenment.
Right.
The heart that generates from field of enlightenment, love, action, contactfulness, you know.
Yeah.
So the fixation of in the Enneagram of the three is trying to do it.
Yes.
Which is glorious, except it's doing it from the personality level, which is exhausting.
Yes.
The adrenals get wiped out, you know.
Yes.
You know how that goes.
And it's exhausting for everybody around them as well.
Yes. Yes. Let's go to the park. Let's go to the park. Without saying, okay, let's rest.
Okay, so then moving on to four.
Yes. Four, when they were born, what was missing in the family is an authentic sense of self.
Yes.
Everybody is like missing their sense of self and getting in their own trip, you know.
And getting their own?
Their own trip.
Trip, you know? Okay.
Yeah. Like the mother could be 8 and she want to demolish that all that there is. And the father could be 5 and want to hide from existence.
Right, right.
Nobody is there in their real self in a simple way, in a glorious way, in a, you know, a beautiful way. So the self was missing in the family.
Right. Right.
The personal self, not the impersonal self.
Right.
This light within.
Yes.
So we call it the inner star or the point of light, you know. So the four suffer so much because what was missing keep eradicating their sense of self. Nobody was looking at them as a person there.
Yes.
Everybody is missing with their own...
busy with their own
with
stuff.
With their own trip. So the baby start to struggle around maintaining this light inside.
Yes.
And by time it even tried to offer it, you know, to mom and dad. You offer them the light. You offer them the spirit, you know. Except they are, you know, they, oh, thank you, you made me feel a little bit good. But they are not interested in your spirit. They are not even interested in your light.
Right.
They are fighting, wanting their own spirit.
Yes.
And the child feels, I am failing. Even my light is not good enough. So they feel wounded about the sense of self, and the drama never end. And then it manifests for the four as this drama, this intensity of the drama. The intensity of the drama, of the fixation, is like an attempt to make a little stone a sunshine.
Yes,
you know?
Yes.
And when they see that, they ease the drama, they feel the loss of the self, then this self emerges within as a being of light, exquisite, gracious. This quality is the central station of what all the Enneagram is seeking. The Enneagram is seeking to resolve how to point or not to point.
How to point or not
to point. How to be the self or not. So the five in the Enneagram says, if I solve the riddle of existence, I could rest, they can put me on my throne again.
Right.
Yeah, the three says, if I can do all the job and affectionately, and then I could they will see me, you know. And one says, if I can make them appreciate each other, and I appreciate other. So all the fixations are attempt to solve the family hole. Then they can be seen and loved and provided for. Since that trip has no end, we alienate farther and farther.
Yes.
The four said, what is really needed is the self.
Yes.
Why are you having third world war? when yes. all you want is your little point of light. Yes. Why are so the four said, I offer. That's why the four is more like sacrificing all the time.
Yes.
But they are really, they cannot sacrifice the point. They yes. cannot give it away.
Yes.
Nor anybody wants it.
Yes.
You know, everybody wants their point. So it's a failing task. But at least the ultimate purpose, you know, for me, is that that we are all trying to find ourselves back to this self. But some went the way of, where is your ears? It's here. You know, and the four says, it's here. It's just not the right ear. It's artificial.
Yes.
You know, because they take the ego to be the point.
Yes.
Their dilemma, they constantly confuse this little ego self with the authentic self.
Yes.
You know, and of course that continually feel shameful, it's a lie, you know, so they are all hiding and all of those things till they, when they discover, yes, their ego is fake. They are fake. They're not authentic. They are not genuine. But the fake one is holding the pose for the genuine one.
Yes.
Then there is forgiveness for the ego. There is integration with the ego. And instead of trying to polish it, make it something different, you appreciate this part of your soul, and then it can, and you know, resolve.
Yes.
So it's
and then you can relax and resolve.
Relax yes. and just be yourself,
yeah.
you know,
yeah.
Share it.
Yeah.
But each fixation, fascinatingly, is it's all about the center of a mandala. In fact, there is another Enneagram superimposed in this Enneagram. I think three corners to it. That reaches a pinnacle of 12, and the top of that pyramid is self, individuated self.
Right, okay. Yeah?
So
okay.
the Enneagram is an attempt to undo the mind and the structures, yes. resolve it in being in the Buddha nature, enlightened nature, then finding our uniqueness. So
right.
the journey starts.
Right. Yeah. Okay. So again, if we move on to the sixth now.
Okay.
Because we've done the five.
The sixth realized that what was missing in the family is the feeling of solidity, of groundedness,
yes.
of intimacy.
Safety.
Safety, perseverance, mm-hmm. you know, will, mm-hmm. you know, the courage to continue to walk the walk, you know. So they begin to struggle around that quality, and which is brilliancy and what we call citadel. It is a quality of essence that when it lands, you really feel solid, relaxed. Your bones, instead of being calcified like rocks, by terror, by fear, you know, and trying to maintain the solid quality that you are reliable and you are iron will, all of that relaxes and a solid structure lands. And you feel it can take care of things.
Right.
I can have my bones breathe again. I
yes.
can have my adrenals rest again.
Right.
Know? So that the six so much trying to be this impeccable warrior.
Yes.
For the others. And right. they can. They can be so loyal, so devotional,
yeah.
so much there, generate a lot of brilliancy and knowing and solidity,
yeah.
but when it comes to walking their walk, it's gone. They don't know how to administer this quality to themselves.
Right.
Once they discover this quality is being used for the others, that's the beginning of recognition and then owning. You know, and then they deal with these issues on the way for this quality to land, and for them to feel safe, secure, grounded, and the courage
yeah.
to walk their walk in life.
Yeah. yeah. And the trust.
And the basic trust comes.
Yes.
To trust,
yes.
you know, that the being provide,
yes.
and the journey continues, and the universe is here for us.
Yes.
You know. While in the depth of the fixation six, there is a feeling of, I am all alone.
Yes.
You know, and because I am all alone, I'll be there for all my people, all my friends,
right.
which is beautiful.
Yeah.
But the moment they apply it, and this applies to all fixations,
sure.
once they apply it to themselves, their personality begin to disintegrate.
Right.
The personality okay. structure is based on the struggle around trying to generate it.
Yeah.
Once there is no need for it, it crumbles.
Right.
Once it crumbles, it could lead to the absolute, mind free from any fixedness, you know. But it also leads to a terror of losing one's identity.
Gosh.
See?
Yes.
What Descartes says, I doubt, therefore I am.
Well, I think.
Yes,
therefore.
I think, therefore I am. So to think or not to think,
yes.
You know, for a four to point or not to point, for a nine to be or not to be, the ego identity is based on this concept.
Right.
And once I don't need to think, I'm just here, the last struggle with the ego begin to emerge, Armageddon starts, then the dissolution of Armageddon.
Wonderful. Okay, now seven.
Seven, when they were in the womb evolving, what was missing in the family is the spaciousness and the openness to look and see all the pieces of the puzzle. You know, mom sees only her view, dad sees only his view, and or they only see the family view versus the world view. There is a funnel vision of perception of reality. And that limitation, of course, leads to fear, leads to lack of trust, leads to not knowing what reality is about. Reality or the perception of reality become limited views and belief systems, you know. So then the baby loses the ability to see the variety of views about reality, and they are all valid, you know, and that reality is greater than those views. So the baby aspires to know the greater plan.
Right.
What is the cosmic view? What is the cosmic plan? And of course, they open that ability, and the family restrict it, you know? Like, you know how dogmas are, you know? You have one belief, you know, and then sometimes we even demonize other people. You know, these are bad people, these are good people. This is, and instead open and being fascinated, you know, with the richness of this culture and richness of this culture and richness of this neighborhood. And this ability to be curious, spacious, is what we call the mind of the presence, the grand mind, the openness that perceive all the pieces fitting together in the puzzle, you know. And in our work, we call it the Diamond Dome.
Right.
The Diamond Dome. And for the audience who are interested in this, there is a mosque in Iran called Shah, S-H-A-H, Chiraq, C-H-E-R-A-G, Shah Chiraq. And they build a dome inside the mosque of tiny mirrors, you know, normal size. And between them, they have lines of colored mirrors, you know.
Wonderful.
Stripe of red, stripe of yellow, stripe of green.
Yes.
And one time in my travel, went there and with a Sufi, and he kept me there the whole day around the shrine of a high being there. The people come to receive blessings. And we sat there, and the sun comes through windows. In the morning, it has certain combination, and the whole dome becomes, let's say, brilliant. Then, as it moves, it hits the red band, then the whole dome becomes red.
Fantastic.
Then and it was breathtaking, really, right. a master architecture, you know, piece.
And the Diamond Dome is the essential vehicle, the essential quality, yes, of the Type 7.
Of the Type 7. I remember my guide said, mind.
Ah.
The cosmic mind, not the absolute.
Yes.
The multifaceted mind that can see the bigger picture, recognize the bigger plan.
Right.
You know, but they made it there, an actual, you know, beautiful.
Wonderful, yeah. Wonderful. Sorry. Type 8?
Type 8 is the animal soul inside. This libidinal force in the baby and the energy for life, you know. There is no force as powerful as the force for life. Nothing, you know, really. Even death is part of it. You know, this is such a force, such a powerful force, that sometimes you see those little plants coming from rocks in the mountains.
Like,
wow, hallelujah. How could they even from rocks come? This force, this love of life, this ecstatic, passionate love of life. Yeah, the wine, when the Christ gave the bread and the wine, he said, this is my blood.
Yes.
And the bread is, you know, this is my flesh,
flesh
or something. What is he referring to? Christ, in my dictionary, in my culture, is a roaring lion, full of love of life, golden pomegranate lion, you know, that came to show us the glory of life. And how we kill it every day by being nailed on the cross, you know. Our cross is our personality.
Yes.
So the love of life, the swine of life, the eight come with it, which is like a tiger, you know, full of life, full of power. The eight is amazing physically, you know, the ability and richness they have in their body is glorious, you know, really glorious. It's misused, fine, and sometimes well used, fine, but to admire this phenomena. So the eight is about generating this ecstatic, passionate love. Different from, you know, pink love.
Yes.
Pink love, soft, cuddly. This one is roaring.
Right.
You want to dance all night. You want to drink wine to infinity. It's like nothing is in your way.
Yeah.
So the baby was struggling in the womb about the absence of life energy in the household.
Right.
You know,
right.
Everybody's like dull and sleeping and no aliveness. So the baby roars, you know.
Yes.
And because it's been struggling around it, eight has so much of this energy. They can go on and on and on,
yeah,
like to infinity.
Yeah.
So this quality is a mixture of what we call black essence,
yes,
which erases mind.
Yes.
Red essence, which erases fear.
Right.
So you have no mind, no fear. You have Zorba. You know, dancing, interacting.
Yes.
Yeah, so the Zorba is the archetype of eight, you know.
Right.
While Buddha is the archetype of five.
I see.
Yeah, so we have,
okay,
Buddha, Zorba, Zorba, the Buddha.
Yeah.
And this quality, of course, is so luscious because it is instinctual. It's like even when it is distorted, still you get amazed at the amount of energy it generates, you know, and especially in the body because it really revives the body.
Yes.
It strengthens it and strengthens the heart to have the courage to walk your walk and to love.
Yes.
The ultimate product of existence, life.
Wonderful.
Yes.
And the vehicle of this, the vehicle?
This one is a dimension, the same as pink.
Right,
an ocean of this pomegranate.
Right.
Within it, there is a pearl, there is a diamond, there is a stupa, there is a chandelier. And one person is this quality, one person is that quality.
Yes, okay. And the nine. And I wonder also, because we talked earlier about including the organs that are related to each type, if we could include with the nine, and then we'll go around the symbol again.
Yes. Nine idealizes normalcy.
Okay.
They just want to be ordinary. That the ultimate dimension is just ordinariness, you know. So why are you fluffing your feathers if you are a three or you are a two or you are... That's narcissistic. They don't want to be narcissistic, you know. So their narcissism is to be not special.
Right. What was the hole in the family then to develop this not special?
So first we define what is normalcy. Right?
Yeah.
What is that normalcy? Normalcy is the only thing that really gives that feeling of normalcy is being itself.
Mm.
Everything is special, everything is something about it. The flowers, all of this. But when you feel being, you feel I'm normal. This feels like I'm coming from insanity to basic sanity, to ease, to relaxation. So the nine is constantly struggling around maintaining the absolute, basic nature, and maintaining a quality in essence we call water, the water dimension. The water dimension has to do with ordinariness, with ease, with relaxation. When you hold the baby's bodies, it's like water. Liquid, you know, but mixed with little gold, so it's gold water, pink water. Babies are adorable, but their bodies is magical.
Yes.
You touch their skin, the suppleness and all of this, you know, and it's pure being relaxing through the body. So the nine is like the whole field was dull or insane or something about it. They're trying to maintain normalcy.
Right.
Normalcy has a sense of balance, ease, you know. And when that's established, then the glory of individuation shine within it.
Yeah.
You know? But they were not allowed to reach that level.
Right.
They got forced to, like, nothing special about you, nothing, you know, you are just one of the kids, and we are just one of the people in the neighborhood, you know. So just be normal, be ordinary, which is true, but not enough. So the nine struggle about how not to create ripples in the household. how to calm the waters.
Yes.
So there is basic sanity. If there are 10 kids in the family, you know, right. Mom is overwhelmed, you know, dad is overwhelmed, and all of a sudden you want gelato.
You know? An ice cream, yes.
An ice cream or something. Then it feels like, who are you? You know, yeah. We can't afford gelato. If you want, then the other kid wants this and the other. So the nine is asked to delete their uniqueness.
To disappear.
To disappear. And just to be normal, don't create ripples.
Yes.
Yeah. In doing so, they have to control an organ that creates this sense of evenness.
Right.
And ease. So they control the pineal gland.
Pineal gland.
The pineal gland has the sense of calming the disturbance in the system, pacifying the conflicting issues, you know, and harmonizing all the energies. But that happens when the pineal gland is released.
Yes.
And it begins to connect you, open the top of the head to the absolute.
Right.
And the absolute come and normalizes you. The absolute is very normal.
Right.
Enlightenment is so normal, nobody wants it. Really, it's like some uniqueness. And the nine then try, how can I maintain the state? Somehow, magically, they can go to the pineal gland, do something there, right? Block it and have it, instead of producing serotonin, melatonin, which is the products that open up in the head when the absolute is there. These qualities bring pleasure, bring ease, bring normalcy, allow all the organs to harmonize without conflicting. Since they cannot reach it, you know, they have to control their emotions, their instincts, their reactivity, their preferences. They control the pineal gland. The pineal gland blocks, and then it produces effects that feels numbness in the body.
Right.
So the nine feel numb.
Right.
And the numbness is like fake normalcy.
Right.
Nothing is, you know, disturbing. It's just like calm water. So that's the specialty of the nine.
Right. And type one?
The medulla, the stem of the brain. The stem,
and what does that do?
Yes, the stem of the brain controls the instincts, the animal impulses. And part of the animal impulses is like sometimes you see that little cubs, they struggle, they fight, they, you know, all of those things. But one is asked to be perfect, to be good. And good kids don't fight. Don't get angry. They don't throw a tantrum. So they are struggling with the natural impulses, you know. They really want to, you know, pick the cat from its tail and swing it. No, that is not, you know, you're not a good girl or a good boy. So then in order to control and
suppress
those impulses, the animal soul, they have to go to the controller of the impulses. Those impulses are in the pelvis. They are in the perineum, in the sacrum, in the solar plexus. These are the instinctual domains.
Right.
You know, in the Enneagram, the instincts are located in the lower centers.
Right.
The passion in the heart and the concept in the head. So they apply this organ of the brain that control the lower centers, right? And shut down the rage, the anger, everything that we call improper.
Right.
To maintain that.
Right.
So they cultivate a lot of
neck problems,
brain, top of the head.
Right.
You know, the nine and the one and the eight, they suffer from the head is shrunk.
Headaches, migraines?
Migraine headaches, dullness,
right.
Limitation of spaciousness inside, right. Limitation of the liquid around the sac of the brain,
right.
Because, you know, the controlling of the pineal gland shrinks the brain.
Right.
The medulla contracts the stem of the brain, then it blocks the top of the head.
Right.
You know?
Okay. Yeah. We need to move on because we're running out of time.
Oh, okay.
Amazingly so.
Yes,
so type two?
Type two is controls the throat.
The throat.
And the diaphragm.
Under
the diaphragm, there is a center.
Right.
You know? That center affects the heart. We call it the Möbius, the center of infinity.
Right.
When it opens, it becomes like a fountain of sweetness.
Right.
From it runs sweet yellow gold.
Yes.
And opens the heart and makes the heart richer.
Right.
You know? And the throat is the center of this expression, manifestation, celebration of the chandelier.
Right.
You know? So to try to control those things.
And three?
Three controls the heart itself and the pericardium.
The pericardium. Where is the pericardium?
A sac around the heart.
Ah, you know? Right.
And that sac, when it is relaxed, it's filled with amberic gold, sweetness, right. Appreciation, value for life, for each other. And because nobody values enough their who they are and what they're doing, they feel so much pain. They shrink the heart.
Oh.
They shrink the pericardium.
Yes.
You know? But then they struggle. They release it. Their heart is gorgeous. They, you know, so beautiful. You know, and then comes the same thing. Nobody sees. Nobody appreciates. So they control these organs. So it's good for them to really be aware of this.
Yeah. And number four, type four.
Number four is the lungs.
The lungs. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So why the lungs? Interesting.
This organ, the lung, has to do with aspiration and inspiration.
Right.
It relates to the spirit.
To the spirit, yes.
And the spirit is this point of light.
Right.
And also the radiance of the absolute.
Yeah. Spirit, the breath.
The breath.
Is the same.
Yes.
Yeah. Right. And then we have five, type five.
Five control the stomach.
Okay.
Yes. The center of their strength is the head.
Right.
The center of their weakness is the stomach. You know. So they have a lot of weakness physically in the stomach. You know, many fives, I know friends and all of that, they in time, they can't eat this and they can't eat that. And, you know, the organs weakens there because their ability to digest and assimilate get blocked.
Right.
And their ability to differentiate, expand.
Right.
But they can't take in because this is more instinctual aspect, animalistic aspect, and they're trying to go to knowledge and higher center.
Right.
They're very powerful in their higher center. Very weak, and also this stomach above it is a center, we call it lunar plexus.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Above the lunar plexus, solar,
yes.
And above it is lunar. The lunar has to do with a will and the ability to surrender.
Right.
And they can't surrender because they think they haven't figured it out.
Right. When they figure it out, then they can, surrender.
Can surrender.
Okay. So type six?
Type six controls the adrenal glands.
Adrenal glands,
yeah.
Okay.
And the large intestine.
Right.
You know? So sometimes they are constipated, sometimes they are diarrhea.
Diarrhea, yes.
And the adrenals get exhausted because they are in a constant fight or flight mechanism.
Right.
So the adrenal is so heightened and the like, when is the attack going to come? Is it a safe thing?
Yes.
So it exhausts them.
Right.
Seven is the small intestine, the ability to assimilate. There they are starving.
Right.
There's so much starvation.
That's the gluttony side of the type
right.
seven.
Right. Instead of strengthening this organ, they think if I can't find the cosmic breast,
yes,
you know,
yes.
all the whole global view, then I can drink from it forever. But you can't have the Akashic records. It doesn't do it. You need some milk, some
yes.
nourishment.
Yes.
Yes.
And the eight?
The eight is the pituitary.
Right.
The
okay.
master gland that, you know, can balance the hormones and all of those things. Eight is extremes. They mm-hmm. are very extremist. And the extremism is due to this gland opening, then there's peacefulness and empowerment, you know, majestic. Closes, then there's the kill. You know, when pituitary gland, it imbalances the hormone, it creates insanity inside. So the eight fears insanity so much, you know, but they are cosmic insanity. Once
right.
they see it,
right.
they can balance this organ.
Yeah.
Relax
yeah.
and allow it to function.
Well, I think it's really fascinating to see how, as spirit, we come into the world with the idea of healing the whole in the family.
Yes.
We create this fixation. We spend our lives in trying to understand or fix the fixation
yes.
and fix whatever. And so In addition to that, I also find fascinating the idea that the organs are connected to each particular type, which I've not come across this before. And so in healing the family whole, we also heal
the organs. Yes. And balance them. Yes, too much heart is too much heart.
Right.
Too much mind is too much mind.
Okay.
To reach this level of equanimity, harmony, and balance. And when you know which organ, you can address it. Nowadays, we live in an incredible field of riches.
Right.
You can have homeopathic, Chinese medicine, I don't know, food, so much to strengthen this organ.
Right.
And
okay.
to balance it.
Okay. So very, very, very briefly, because we're literally less than a minute, what kind of suggestion could you make to people to embody, to be the essence that we all are intrinsically, and somehow we have lost sight of that?
Yes. I think the essential Enneagram helps define our psychological dilemma and what we are doing. By having this riddle eased, resolved, something happened very beautifully. When I realized that my family hall was about specific thing, and when I felt it, you know, like, what am I trying to do with my ego? And I felt that's ultimately what my ego is trying to do. I checked, do I really want that? No, that has nothing to do with me.
Right, so right, so you let go of that.
I let go, it spontaneously started to go, and that gave me a deeper connection to who am I. If I am not this, what am I?
Yeah.
And that led to discovery
so
of the self.
So in healing yourself, you're actually healing your family rather than trying to heal the family.
Exactly. You heal yourself, including letting go of this quality.
Yes.
When you reach that dimension of openness, you know, then the quality is balanced. You have it.
Yes.
You know, because you already have too much of it, balanced. And the greater space of openness, instead of the mind and the fixation blocking the absolute, it opens to the absolute, to the field of richness. In that field, you can interact with the souls of your parents, even if they are not here.
Wonderful.
You send them the blessings.
Yeah.
We all got caught in the absence of gold, and here it is. And from what I know, no time and space is between us and our loved ones.
Wonderful,
In that level, we can function in multidimensionality.
Thank you. On that note, we've got to stop. And if you want to find out a little bit more about the basics of the Enneagram, we have a whole series on the Enneagram on our website. So if you're interested in finding out, as I said, the basics, there we are. Faisal, thank you so much for coming. And it's been a little bit of a marathon, but we made it.
Yes.
And thank you so much for watching Conscious TV. And we'll see you again very soon. Thank you. Goodbye.